Farouk here with GenConnect.com, and today we're joined right in the heart of New York City by Alexa Von Tobel, the founder of LearnVest.com. Thanks for being here, Alexa.
Thanks for having me.
So we are right in the middle of the holiday season, and people make a lot of money mistakes, a lot of finance mistakes while they're shopping and preparing for the holidays.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about some great holiday money tips that people should keep in mind as they're shopping and preparing.
Sure. So first, just to think about it. So right now, people today, as of October of 2011, are carrying 14.1 million Americans are carrying debt from last holiday season. So just keep that in mind. You know, you run crazy during the holidays. You get really overexcited. People spend on average $712. And then you think about it, a year from now, think about carrying that debt. You don't want that. So ultimately, the goal is enjoy the holidays, live them up to the fullest, but without putting your finances in jeopardy for years to come.
So what are some common pitfalls that people should avoid while preparing for the holidays?
So some basic things. First, a lot of people run out, go shopping, and the oldest and best tip is an old-fashioned shopping list. Make a list. Who are you buying gifts for? Who do you need to buy gifts for? What's the range you want to buy them in? Put it in your pocket or in your purse or your wallet and carry it with you, and that'll actually be ever-present to help make sure that you don't overspend. Next, be careful of some of the holiday tricks that retailers are using, such as if you run around with an oversized shopping cart, you're 37% more likely to spend than you would be if you're carrying a small basket. People tend to spend, they're 17% more likely to spend when they're listening to holiday music. You'll realize stores are blasting it. That's not on accident. It's because you get really excited and caught up in the season and you tend to overpurchase. And then lastly, people tend to be much smarter about spending if they're carrying things like a $100 bill or a $50 bill in cash rather than their credit cards. People, for whatever reason, study shows, don't like to actually break large bills. I mean, think about it. You're much more likely to break a $5 bill than you are a $50 bill.
Right.
And therefore, it's really smart to walk around with cash when you're doing your holiday shopping because you won't have those impulse urges and you'll be 48% less likely to spend an impulse shop, which is not good.
Right, of course. And so what are really the best ways to give generously to your family and friends while still being financially responsible?
Yeah, so give activities. So, I mean, first of all, it doesn't mean to be Scrooge. Go out and buy the holiday gifts. Just be thoughtful about it and be thoughtful about not getting caught up in the entire experience of overspending and the frenzy. Give experiences, though. You have to remember, when you give someone a gift, that means that they feel liable to give you a gift back. So let's say, Brooke, we're not buying holiday gifts this year. Let's just go out to dinner. Let's go see a play. Let's go do something that we can experience that we're both going to be excited about. And it means we don't have to go and buy each other a gift on top of that. I think those are some smart things. And then don't forget the power of a simple handwritten note. This is the time of year to tell people that you love them. Spend the time to do that. And that doesn't always mean a big, giant present. Sometimes it just means being really thoughtful with your words.
Alexa Von Tobel with some great ways to get the most bang for your buck at the holidays. Thanks for watching, and for more with Alexa, be sure to watch GenConnect.com.